Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome back to the Imagine Cruising 2024 World Indoor Bowls Championships. We're live, as always, from the beautiful Potters Resorts here in Hopton-on-Sea. So, second of the World Open Singles semi-finals. Well, it's a clash of the titans. Alex Marshall, MBE, takes on his best friend, Paul Foster, MBE. It's going to be a classic. So let's have a look at what we have for the rest of the day. Well, this evening's game, 7:30. It's the grand final of the World Under 25 Singles. It's English qualifier, Rebecca Morby, taking on the Scottish qualifier, Darren Miller. For the players who are just finishing their trial ends here, it's going to be a good game, as I said. Alex Marshall, well, he's won this six times before. He's here as a sponsor's choice. Paul Foster, five times. So Paul will be going to try and make that an equal for the best friends. Hard to say. I mean, I'm not sure who we fancy here, but either way, it's going to be an absolutely fantastic game. Great to see Alex back on the carpet. He always seems to feel home here. Loves playing on this rink and also within the venue. Paul, well, it was just a class act. It was absolutely outstanding last night. So we're going to hand over very shortly now to the BBC coverage. Have a great afternoon. Bye for now.
Thank you very much, Rishi. Yes, it's time to bring out our players for this, our second semi-final match of the afternoon. And our first player out for this match, we have a man with 14 World Championship titles, including five times former World Pairs and six times former World Singles Champion. Currently ranked number 18 in the world, it's Scotland's Alex Marshall, MBE. Opponent for this match is five times former winner of this event with a total of 13 World Championship titles. Also from Scotland, your world number one, Paul Foster, MBE.
Alex Marshall gets the first jack delivered. Hasn't been a lot of time for the players to prepare for this game. Yes, practice this morning if you wish to, or indeed you could practice last night. But in between the first and second semi-finals, only a couple of ends available to you.
Pat Francis, my ball.
20 inches short of Jack Hyde.
Has gone up after his second ball, now walking back down the rink. Paul doesn't follow up after his second ball very often.
One green.
That might change at the semi-final. Heads might be very close.
Marshall Penn, the winner. So, touch of two.
Half an inch short of Jack Hyde.
So often happens whenever you change your hand to drop a yard short. Correction will be made, of course, with the next bowl, but you may or may not get an opportunity. It's a good ball. It's Alex's wife, Diane. It's a good ball. It's a shoulder to rest off, but I don't think you're going to get the shot off it.
No, not quite close enough for Paul to get shot by sitting on it.
Wow, that was special.
Made that to perfection.
And shot, Paul Foster.
Making contact with Alex Shotball.
Set score, 0-1.
Touch of the jack. Jack doesn't actually move. That's a really strong ball.
A lot of movement at this time. A match because obviously after the first game there's a certain amount of people who want to leave the arena comfort break, come back in again, and
it
takes
and
a little
half,
while. It's a big stand, that takes a little while to make your way up or down the stairs and get settled into your seat. Just have to take a few moments.
Thank you. 2 feet past Jack High.
A summer ball will drop back, post the shot. Alex Marshall will be going back to Australia fairly soon. Plays in so many events over there.
On green. It's an inch short of Jack High.
It's also the league programme too. There's some very wealthy clubs to play for. Going with a timing shot here. Try and get the ball of Jack. Jack preferably.
Jack!
Just under.
Oh, I just needed an edge of that. Paul will be aware of the fact that Alex will probably go again. Only one bit of danger here for Alex if he does play this. If he gets the green balls into his own red balls, he could be in a bit of bother. He'll end up losing two or three shots, and that might change his delivery. But he's so confident on the running ball.
Try and draw the jack now, surely.
Yeah. He's recognised the danger. Try and pull the jack if he can.
One shot, Paul Foster. Set score 0-2 after 2 innings.
I don't think I've ever seen the arena fill up as quickly for the second game in the afternoon. Just show how important this one is.
This is not a silly crowd. They know what they're in for here. And they don't want to miss a moment.
Expectations were high. It's proving that these guys are well up for this.
Alex's bowl, 2.5 inch gap.
This is so good. Well played, Paul.
Wow. Yeah, that's impressive.
Two green.
Ball's last ball touching.
It is, yes.
Just nestling in there. Touching the jack as well. Back in two.
Well, you either go deep with this one and hit it, or you go hitting now and go deep later. You don't want to draw that off. Yeah, going early. Got it.
Good strike, Alec. Following it in the ditch as well. Nice bonus.
Ball's not a toucher, so it gets taken away. Very confident shot.
Two green.
Interesting, Paul changed his hand onto the backhand for that shot.
Just under 6 feet.
6 feet.
6 feet.
Alex looking at the side monitor in there. Yeah, well, you sure about that? I'll take Francis Fletcher's word for it. A bit closer to the action. Made it.
And the just, is it enough?
Well, he's saying that's a small 6 feet. This will stop. Looks like it's going in a bit of a pace.
Oh, a little bit swift. Just in.
Just looked like it was arriving a little bit quick. Ball needed to bend the shade more. If it had have actually tailed off, it would have stayed in.
It lost pace quite quickly, actually, right at the end.
Score 2-2 after 3 eggs.
Alec is still mentioning the 6 feet. Wasn't happy with that measurement, was he?
One man's 6 feet is another man's 5.5. Hard to tell without a tape measure.
Jack length, 28.5 metres. Inches.
Paul Foster's now starting, and has been actually for a while, getting the invitations down into playing Premiership Bowls down in Australia. And but of course, it takes a long time. You're away from home for many weeks, and
two red.
It can be difficult. Something's wrong.
Didn't like that.
Yep, I think it's the weight, the
yeah,
line's
just
okay.
Over.
Well, the standard of these two players, that's a relatively loose end, but those are the dangerous ends. Those are the ones you can lose a three or a four. Alex Marshall, line two.
Slightly let off there, if that's still two.
Two red.
Yes, he has, but I think from Alex Marshall's point of view, he'll be thinking, I needed a real good first shot.
Very cool.
That's the reason why he expected Paul to draw the shot, and he did.
So score 2-3 after 4 inches.
Rosie, our friendly Labrador. Hearing dogs for deaf people. This is the third year that Rosie's been here. Likes to come and visit. And very popular she is too.
Just under.
Very good.
Stuart Anderson having made his way to the final. Will now have to change bowls to his red set. He's been playing with green for the last few matches. And if Alex was to win this game, he'd have to change from red to green. Paul Foster, well, he'd be quite happy because he's staying in green. Lovely track with this one.
Yeah, he's good again here. Ramping up the pressure here on this end.
Yes, just looking to see what the situation is for the back here, and there's a one red ball. Paul's are all front balls, and that's a little hiding shot. It'll be hard to get that one out. Paul agrees, that's why he's trying to draw it.
Alex Marshall.
Surprisingly, that one. Played two beauties, but just dropped short.
Set score 4-3 after 5 ends.
Alex Marshall's wife, Diane.
Jack length, 28 and a half metres.
Just stopped a little bit abruptly because that's where the seam of the carpet is. It has to be sewn somewhere. No seams run across the rink. The well roller down every time and as flat as they possibly can be. Good ball. This Two rink green. Is playing well. The boys are playing well on it, but it's allowing them to do that. Everything finding centre rink.
Jack
didn't last very long. Goodness me. That's one of the hardest shots to play.
Couple of options down there. Got Paul's shot bowl. Jack flicks across the other side of the rink, and Alex goes in the same direction.
Yes, and his ball stayed on the rink as well. That was a bonus. Oh, this is wide. This is going to be skirting very close. Ooh. Had a little look at the side ditch and said, no, I'll not bother, thanks.
On the shot.
My goodness me, he really did push that out. There's Alex saying to him, we're an inch away.
Very close to the ditch, as we can see.
Goes in there, of course, it's a dead ball. Alex playing off the front edge of the mat, so he's taking a slightly different line. Oh, how's his weight?
Just overplayed this. Chance of Paul to add another.
And the line was perfect, just the extra weight.
Score 4-5 after 6 ends.
Well, the lead just swapping around for the last couple of ends. 3 ends to go.
Jack Lake, 27.5 metres.
Rink's just playing a little bit slower this year, and I think that's actually benefited some of the players because it can get very quick and has been previously. But it also means that players are used to playing on the very fast surface and drop short very easily. Doesn't hurt things in the backhand. Forehand is available on the draw, but he might just decide to play a little runner at this and try and open things up. He's so confident with the running ball. We'll know from the way he's standing. Well, if it's on the backhand, he's probably playing a little bit into it. That's just to open it up. A smattering of clamp.
Yeah, well, actually, he's hit the target absolutely perfectly. I think maybe because they can see he's still down, but we know that he's given himself a chance with his final delivery. He might be down, but there's a lot of room, and you'd certainly be expecting him to cut down, if not have a close shot here.
It's not moving much. Oh, he's played it.
Wow.
That was...
all the pace coming off at the end there.
Well, that will secure the shot because Alex Marshall cannot afford to play up to that, just to rest it off. Now, normally he would play up, touch the ball out, stay in its place, but if he was to miss it, that's going to be a very soft three shots.
Alex knew the shot clock was just running down there. Stopped his question mid-flow. Just been looking for a good second here.
Absolutely no need to do anything more than that.
One shot, Paul Foster.
A little bit of communication between the players, as you would have expected in this game.
So it's been 4-6 after 7 innings.
Very much concentrating previous games, staying away from his opponents, keeping that real focused head on. But with Alex, it's a whole different story. Best friends for a long, long time.
Jack length, 29 and a half metres.
Really good. Good opening bolt. Backs up the last end. Alec on the draw, played one here.
Beautiful adjustment.
4 inch gap. Timeout called. Paul has four timeouts remaining.
Paul's just having a look at the side monitor. Just hidden round the back to get a good look at this. He can use the edge of the bowl. Needs to be reaching. Just won the red. At least has a shot in the forehand to turn the jack if he wants it.
Timeout called. Alex,
that's what he's looking at. He's going to play it. He's going to have to play it slightly on the wide side because he really doesn't want to come into that front green one. The green one, this one here, is dangerous. And he doesn't really want to be hitting that. The alternative is the backhand, a little touch on his own bowl. No reason why he can't play that. There's a little tap there and make a two. Drop inside to make two.
Solid contact would be good too. Second ball. There's an option down there.
Very close for the second shot. Really close. Going to have to try and get things in there. Can't take that away.
Two shots, Alex Marshall.
Knew if we took that away that it would be dropping the ball in, so.
Set score 6-6 after 8 ends.
Well, very few people could call this game. The way Alex have been dropping out of the top 16 over the last sort of year or two, that you'd think really with Paul being so established at the top,
Paul
would be
a
firm favourite. But because Alex has come in under the wildcard system, he's played so well and looks so comfortable on the rink that it's a toss of a coin, it really is.
Two feet short of Jack Hunt.
Alex has dropped this ball short on Paul Foster's line. Prefers the backhand.
Please,
gap on the shot bowl 20 inches.
Move to the forehand. It's just a more open hand to terms of getting a good draw shot close to the jack. But very easy to drop short on it.
There's a bit of a wall here now.
Yes, this is all about who can get one around the front balls.
That can's okay for Alec because it's his own ball coming in. It's ideally looking for either side of it, but the option is there to turn it a little bit like this. Weight was good.
Yes, good firm connection. It's the last end of the set though, and it's only a matter of scoring the shot. That's really a one-end shootout, so. Might be worth being a little bit aggressive to this. You can still draw it on the backhand, but oh goodness, that's tough. He's drawn it on the forehand. He'll have to correct on his last weight. He's not sure about this. Just looked a little bit heavy. Well, back position secured. Don't think he'll risk the next one on a draw. What Alex is looking at is the front green ball.
Timeout called.
Paul gets
Alex
into
has
that.
Three timeouts remaining.
He can either go to the jack or can go to that other bowl, and that would give him the shot that he needs to win the set. So what does Alex do? Well, it's a tricky one. Best position, I think, is probably around just behind it here, around about there. So if his bowl does go out, at least he secures the shot. There's a chance of Jack hitting it.
Needs his bowl to do two jobs in a way, David, doesn't he? Cover and count as well.
Yeah. It's a hard one because there's dual aspect to it. Well, he's going deep. He's just thinking, you know what? I think Paul's going to hit this, and I want to be the best back bowl. Yep, it's as good a choice as any. You know, if you're not really quite sure what's going to happen, the default choice is usually to go as the best back one. Ball on contact.
Got it.
Nori, who's line second
hit.
Shot? Is it green?
I think it's Paul. Yeah, Paul had second with that front bowl. That's why he needed to play the bowl clean. Didn't want any jack movement there because Alec could put the position in.
Well, it was really very difficult. You can't cover two positions with one ball. Not completely. Paul Foster had to play a beauty to get it. You see the jack lengths, the guys have been going long most of the time. Even 27 and a half is beyond middle length.
Jack length.
Both these players have a sort of default choice of a 23, 24. Either jack length, that's what they enjoy. No one's going there as yet.
Thank you.
10 inches, Francis.
Your ball, 10 inch gap.
Little room. Slow to get back that side. Just fights it until the last foot or so of travel, but the weight wasn't bad. Just wouldn't swing back in. It's a very precise hand. Precise side of the rink. Get one even closer. Could be three.
Three red.
Line looks better for the job. Let's just sit on that bowl. Oh, well done. Very good recovery bowl there from Paul Foster.
And that's why Alex Marshall was so keen to get his third bowl close to the jack. Tucked away, difficult to get at.
This is good. Can he make a good connection? Oh. He has. What a bowl, Alec Marshall.
What a bowl and what a result as well. The jack bounced forward.
Yeah.
Three shots, Paul Foster.
Wow.
Correction, Alex Marshall.
It was a very good ball, a key time, but what a result to get three out of it.
One end.
Great ball.
Both players playing brilliant bowls. Last
length,
delivery.
9.5 metres.
Once again, Alex Marshall going up after a second bowl.
Three.
Nudge the jack.
Played it perfectly. And it right through to his own waiting ball.
Another conversion shot.
Two red. Back bowl is the shot.
The gap.
Gap on the shot bowl, 3 inches.
Tough one to get out of. Needs to rest the red ball at the bottom of your picture. Very easy to crash into the front one. That's not going to help because Alex can add another. It's not easy to add another, but it's a very secure two at the moment. Close again, all acknowledging the ball with a clap. Better than close, brilliant.
Three excellent bowls here from Alec Marshall.
That's a tough position to get out of. Everything in line, you have to try and judge it past the front balls.
Ball switching over to his backhand. He's looking to sit on the shot bowl. Needs to bend quicker now, just on the outside of it.
Well, it's not unusual for any ball to pass on the wide side with an extra bit of weight. But this is a great start for Alex Marshall in the second set.
Set score 6-0 after 2 minutes. Length 28.5 metres.
Last one, is it short?
About half an inch short of Jack High.
One red.
It's always good to see the first balls in because that opens up all sorts of opportunities.
Alex backing it up with the second. Very good lead in.
One red.
Well, that's a player's view, which is actually interesting to see because that's what they can see from the mat. Quite like that shot. That gives you an idea of just how far the jack is away.
Two red.
If anybody ever thought that Alex Marshall had lost any of his skills by dropping out of the top 16, you can see he hasn't. What's under unless he comes back off it? He's in trouble in this set already. Alex Marshall's really stepped up. There'll be a bit of pace coming into this. Doesn't really matter which side he plays it. He needs damage limitation, but Jack out in the re-spot would be good. There's one green one lurking out there.
Just be looking to make a good connection and clear something. Doesn't want to be dropping a third three in a row. He's got it. Yeah,
oh,
that was
wow.
Great. What a strike that was. All three balls gone.
I wasn't sure if all three could go on the backhand. That proves the point, they could.
Foster. That was a huge bowl at this point in the set. 9-0 down is a big difference to 6-1.
6-1 after three ends. Jack length, 27 metres.
Ball short, Francis.
Your bowl 18 inches short of Jack High.
And once again, Alex Marshall has sort of blocked the way on Paul's favourite hand, backhand going away from the commentary position. But because it's Alex Marshall's bowl, he can play away at it.
One green.
Yeah, a much better one. Much better one. Shan the wet sitting. It's a much closer ball and feel a bit happier about it.
That's right.
Thank you.
I've made second.
One green.
Yeah, so Paul's aware of the fact that he needs to score almost every end now to get right up to six all, give himself a chance. He's missed the line on the low side, that just sucks it up. Marshall looking to see if he can get at this.
Just looking. Good connection. It's a lot of the front, that was the problem.
Ooh, yeah.
He's unlucky with that result.
He was underneath.
Very blocked there though, wasn't it?
Yeah, he was underneath the line, but you know, if you're going to miss it, you sort of say, well, fair enough, missing it, so but giving another one away, that just didn't even look possible.
A little touch off of Paul Foster's front bowl. Alex Waite was always good, of course, but that little clip just put him right onto the jack. Just not quite getting the right angle there.
Yeah, the ball was just beyond where he needed it to be.
Two red.
This is close. Needs to bend quicker now. It's just going to get that gap again.
Ooh, what an effort.
The weight was really good for the job there.
Any touch in that jack, he was guaranteed shot. Full contact. He was looking at two, maybe three. So many gaps, isn't there? He's just keeping the concentration levels.
Two shots, Alex Marshall.
Marshall continues to control this set. 8-3.
Jack length, 28.5 meters.
Alex is not sure about these distances.
Oh, he knew where to place the mat.
To be a feature of Alex's game now. He comes up after the second ball in that direction.
Yeah, he's on that an awful lot during this game. We noticed it earlier in the week too.
Yes, he probably needs to win, well, probably three of the next four, if not all four, to win this match. Otherwise, we're into a tie break. But 8-3 is a commanding lead.
To play this with a perfect weight. Even if it's not short, it's a very good ball.
Favourite red.
It's a very delicate shot. Clear the front one, get to the red.
Great ball here, well done.
And, it didn't drop. Thought it would, but he's shifted it on the carpet a little bit. That might make two. We definitely favour two. Not well. Alex is coming down to have another look at this. His difficulty is what we believe.
And I'm cold.
Someone in the crowd, I think, just reminded Alex that he had 2 seconds left on the stop clock.
It's always a little bit of help, it's always
Alex
useful.
Has 2 timeouts remaining.
So, but he's looking at angles to see what can happen here. The green balls are in a position. That's number one. That's number two. There's no back position worth talking about at the moment. If he comes racing into this, this is his last ball. What happens? Well, he might take one away, but I just can't
two
see
green.
Him taking the two away. There's a red ball onto green ball. Now, if the green ball and the jack go into the ditch, he'll have second shot, but he's not even attempting to play that. Paul Foster was at first to get a hand slap there with Alex Marshall. That was unbelievable.
Inch perfect, touched nothing, skirted past his front red ball to draw an amazing shot there.
Absolutely no way to get the shot on a running ball. Absolutely no chance.
He knew he was good, calling
Paul
it in.
3 timeouts remaining.
Yes, that was perfect. That was absolutely perfect. And now Paul Foster's under a lot of pressure. 2 shots there is really what he needed. And he's probably going to have to run into this with weight and hope for a good result. That's what he's trying.
He's got something.
What? Oh, has he got the shot?
Yeah, he's made the shot out of this by the looks of it.
No idea where that jack was going to go. Good hit, but he had to rely on a little bit of luck to get the shot out of it.
Set score 8-4 after 6 ends.
Well, I don't think anyone would have anticipated the jack ending up there. Great end of balls. Alex Marshall's draw shot probably deserved to win it, but
that
Paul
was
Foster.
Wasn't it?
Exactly. Paul Foster's balls before that were brilliant as well.
Yeah.
Slightly shorter this time. Normally in this position, the player ahead and they're going into the seventh end. If they win this end, the chances are they're going to win the set. That's what most of the stats would say.
One red.
And against Paul Foster, well, you think you'd need a little bit of a cushion. Paul's aware that he needs to score at least a single.
One red.
A good bow.
One red.
Just getting in between the red and the green here. Of a positional boat. Still holding the one.
Difficult one for Paul because he just drew this, but the two poles will go. And that's what he's after. Oh, it looks narrow unless he comes off something.
Jack's second option. Oh, he did go right through with it.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. What a ball. Wow.
Well, Foster had the percentages down there. Managed to pick up the Jack clean. Follow it right through into the ditch.
One green.
Well, it's one to green. All his balls are up now. Alex is going to... Well, it's a tough one to draw another one. Or to draw the shot. But at least he knows he's only losing a single. So he can give this a real go. Drops in the ditch, it doesn't matter. Oh, it's not bending. It's just stopped bending. If it had been bending there at the end of its travel, it had a good chance.
One shot, Paul Foster.
This is a titanic battle, it really is.
8-5 after 7 minutes.
Alec has been so consistent, particularly in this second set. Paul has really pulled out some big bowls at crucial moments to keep himself in with the chance. Three down with two to play.
Jack Lang, 29 and a half metres.
Potter's Resort really enjoying this. Battle of the Giants, really, of the sport of indoor bowls.
My ball, Francis.
Your ball, 10 inches short of Jack High.
Again up for the second ball. This is something he's got used to. Keeps the legs moving. Doesn't have to wait for the next one then. As soon as Paul plays it, he's allowed to start walking up the rink. Without shot clock and a time match, that wouldn't be allowed. But it's not where he wants it to rest. He knows it's too green, but really needed that one on the jack.
Jack
He's trotting up after this. He's on a beautiful line. This is all about weight.
I don't know if he's got enough. Oh, he has got enough. He's just under. I said it wasn't quite right with it.
Yes, he was on a beautiful line because why I said that was because he was coming off his own balls.
Yeah, had them there to use, didn't he?
You don't want to be on a wide line going into that simply because it holds off. But if you're on the slightly inside line, you use the wall, you come back off it. Well, Foster joined for three. Well, this would be massive. It's hanging off on a line again.
He's counting.
It is. It's the number one shot, but I don't think he'll expect to score three here.
Yeah.
Not the way that's sitting. That's too wide a target for Alex Marshall.
It's the only benefit is there are gaps there.
Well, the gaps are the problem, obviously, but you know, I think really
timeout call.
He won't want to go too wide on this. So it'll be fairly direct getting into those two balls. He has got the back position. That's a given, the way that's sitting. It's this ball here is absolutely vital. But if he gets into the front one, if he's a little bit in the tight side or wants to play the forehand, that ball's coming off the green one and into the others. So lots of options available for Alex Marshall here. There's only one thing he probably won't try and do, and that is to draw it. Yeah, going for the forehand runners. It's got his own balls there.
He's got the jack. Well played, Alec Marshall. Absolutely nailed that.
That's what he needed, and Paul Foster did that before, so brilliant, absolutely brilliant from Alex Marshall.
Yeah, got the jack clean as a whistle here, followed it all the way through.
Landed in beside it, that didn't matter. It was the last ball of the end anyway. He was always going to score as soon as it went through. And it's an uphill struggle now to score four on the last end in this match. It hasn't really been a proper sniff of a four. Ooh, where's the jack going? Wow, he's lost it. That's a surprise. Jack goes back whenever it goes into the ditch and your opposition gets the chance to adjust the mat, which Paul has already done. And he'll play a different length. Or will he? This going
that
in
length,
as well?
Nope.
Well, that's the length that Alex was playing anyway, so it doesn't really matter. He's moved the mat a little bit, just a yard or so. So I think Paul will be resigned here, Shan, to a tie break.
Absolutely. I mean, four's a tall order against anyone, isn't it? But Alec Marshall, the way he's playing, very, very tough for Paul here.
Short ball. That's me all. He knows that's the end of that. They'll just roll these balls up and down. I can't imagine Alex will do anything here except just draw up.
Two red.
Two red.
Good effort with this. Second shot. Paul wants to keep his team. He wants to keep his concentration, as does Alex, because you know we know this set's now effectively over. And the 3-end tiebreak will be coming up. Foster just said, I bring the ball up because he knew it was over.
One shot, the second set.
Just impossible to score four shots. Toss the coin to see who's going to have the option.
Paul won the toss and has elected to give Alex a jack on the first end.
So, Malik will play the jack the first end. He'll have the option the next end, whether he wants to keep the jack or give it away. Paul Foster won the toss, so he had the choice. We'll go back to Paul again on the third end if it's needed. So win the end. Doesn't matter how many shots you get, just win it.
Length 28.5 meters.
Well, that was a brilliant set. It really was fantastic. The first one was good, but that was a marvelous set. Alex Marshall played it extremely well, but he got off to a good start. 2 threes that made all the difference in the end. I think it's fair to say, Sean, this game deserved a tie break.
It did. It was what everyone was hoping for. I think it's a fitting Red. Result for how the players have both played as well.
10-inch gap.
And Alex Marshall back to his imperious best here in the single rink. A lot of good tactical play as well, as you would expect. Not the best result. It's in the ditch, and we've seen both players play to the edge of the ditch. And because there's no accumulated shots here, they're just going to have to play right up to it. the forehand has a problem because of the short bowls, and you'd have to come around those and hope that you bend back, but you just have to skirt past them. The narrow side is exactly that, narrow.
That's a good third ball from Alec.
Both these players are using big bias bowls. Hard to hold the bowl up. As long as you, well, Paul's right on the front, in the front inside edge. That's where you need to be. You're playing across the line. The bowl holds up for a long, long time before it even starts to bend. Now, has he got the weight?
Not quite enough this time.
One red.
I'd like to have made it with the first one, but pressure's on here, Alex, to make the second again. He's also up at the front inside edge to try and hold the bowl up as long as possible. Ooh, he didn't make it, but what he has done is he's narrowed down the chance of taking that other red ball out.
He really has. That was second prize. I mean, you can see from the angle there, that's so much tighter for Paul Foster to take off the rink now.
Yeah, he wouldn't even have been thinking about that. He'd have been just wanting to sneak in front. I think Paul, you know, still a tough one to draw, but
he's going for the bolt. You know, it's not surprised.
Narrow target.
He's close. He needs to get down now.
Oh, has he hit his own over enough? Wow. It's a measure by the looks of it, and it's going to be, oh dear me. If that ball had dropped once more, it was shot. Oh, I think Alex might feel maybe lying, but Paul. The problem for judging this is that the ditches are deep enough to use up inches. Depends on the angle you're coming at. I thought Paul Foster had that shot. It looked good. Thought he was inside for the red one. Francis Fletcher just waiting to get his side off the measure, because that's the one that will have to go down into the ditch. So.
Marshall.
Quick measure. Paul just said, yep, no problem. On it is. Alex Marshall has said to Paul, you take the jack, I want the last ball on this occasion. Alex Marshall
jack
is one end away
meters.
From another World Indoor Final.
Shake of the head from Paul in an ideal world. He wanted to be closer. Yes, he's got two, but they're
about a quarter inch
A-beatable when they're to kind of rest on two.
About half inch gap.
Half inch gap between the balls. He's not interested in what it is to the jack. Jack in the ditch, two balls out would be the preferred shot. He thinks he's close here.
He's very close. He's got the bowls.
Got nothing. Wow.
Kicked the bowl.
Oh dear me.
How can he make contact with the bowl with that sort of pace and not move it?
Paul has to change this.
Yeah, Paul's on a flatter line here.
Yeah, he's trying to draw another shot and be away from the other two.
Two green.
Still two green. The red ball still counts. Alec will go again.
Interested again. He's got the jack. Didn't get it clean.
No, he didn't, and that's in a bad place, I can tell you. If that doesn't go on the respot, that is going to be a nightmare to get to.
Alex did get the jack, obviously wanted it full as it was, squeezed it right over to the corner, just inside the confines of the rink.
Yeah, he knows that too. Well, both players will know it. This is going to be tough. First of all, we need to know who's lined the shot.
One red.
One to red. So Alex Marshall is actually lined a match-winning position at the moment. So Paul Foster can't afford to go into the ditch. And he can't afford to be too short.
Paul has three timeouts.
Doesn't look like there's much going across the rink. Oh, he's going to play across the rink. This is going to be tough. You never play this line normally, so it's very hard to judge what the weight is.
He's given this a good look. He's played one here.
Oh, what a ball.
Well done, Paul.
Oh, what a shot, Paul Foster. Brilliant, brilliant ball. And Alex Marshall, well, there's only one thing for him to do, take the ball off. And I'll be honest with you, if I was to pick any man in the world to play a ball off.
Two.
Very hard to play across the head like Paul did. Fantastic ball.
Timeout called. Alex has one timeout remaining.
A clap to say, well played, but he's just keeping his concentration, asking a question. So we've either one end to go, or this will be the last ball of this match. As I was saying, if there's going to be one player to take a ball off in the world, I would pick Alex Marshall. He's got it!
He's got it!
Oh, what a ball!
Cracking ball, Alex Marshall. It's the tie break and this match.
We expected so much from this, and two great, great friends. No one would be more pleased for Alex than Paul Foster, and he knows it. What a fantastic game of bowls. Absolutely brilliant. Well, the crowd on their feet, they really enjoyed that. It was superb stuff. There's tears in the eyes of the family. 6-7, 10-5 when Alex just came into the zone, and a two-end tie-break, which was absolutely brilliant. Ends one.
a quite incredible match has come to a conclusion. We're running out of time to bring that to you. Thankfully, it's come to a conclusion, but in the most dramatic circumstances, just talk me through what that victory has meant to you today. Looks like you're still shaking, Tati.
No, I'm not shaking. It's just the fact that when you're in such a tough game against probably the number one in the world at this present moment in time. My form's not been great against Paul in recent years, although he's been just phenomenal. But today, I felt I just could do nothing wrong. I felt so confident on the rank. I felt relaxed. I felt I could beat any bowl. And, you know, it's shot for shot on many times. But what a match. Absolute fantastic match. And thanks to the crowd. Thank you.
We have been royally entertained today. Just a brief word on looking ahead to the final tomorrow against Stuart.
Stuart's a class act. You know, if I can perform like that tomorrow, I think I've got a chance. Well, that'll be a fantastic game. Stuart's a class act, so it'll be a great game.
Well, it will be a great match. A great match today has come to a conclusion. Congratulations to Alex Marshall, back in the final once again. Commiserations to Paul Foster. We, of course...
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there's not often I'm lost for words, but that was absolutely amazing. Alex Marshall is certainly back in the top 16 with a bang. Unlucky to Paul, probably beating most people on the day, but it's Alex that goes through to the final tomorrow and plays Stuart Anderson. So let's have a look what we have for the rest of the day. Well, 7:30 this evening, we have the final of the World Under 25 singles. It's going to be Rebecca Morbey from England taking on Darren Weir from Scotland. I'm afraid that is all we have time for this afternoon, so I hope you've had a great day. I've certainly enjoyed it, and we're back tonight. Bye-bye for now.
I'd never been invited to do anything like that.
You know, the old days of the boring holiday are over, I'm afraid, ladies and gentlemen.